My advice to those in ministry is, as you approach potential patrons to come alongside you, you need to have three things in your view, and they all begin with P. The first is partnership, is getting alongside and saying, is this somebody who, shares my vision and can, can be a friend through this process and can provide the resources and the skills and so on that I need, so partnership. But that partnership also needs to have a couple of other elements. One is there needs to be permission. And so if I'm a minister, I want to have a patron who will support me, but isn't going to dictate to me. And we can talk a little bit more about, how business people, some of the pitfalls as a business person coming in as a patron. But I think as a minister, I want somebody who I can rely on and I can ask advice of, but ultimately is going to give me the permission to pursue the ministry that I've been, called to pursue. And then the third is patience. And again, one of the pitfalls as a business person is I have businesses that I'm responsible for. I'm looking for outcomes, I'm looking for results. If they don't hit the results, then, we need to take, action. Ministry doesn't always work like that. God's economy sometimes works differently. I always recall the story of Don Carson's father, who labored in French-speaking Canada for years and years and years and saw very little fruit. And yet after he died, I think, there was revival in French-speaking Canada. Lots of seed sown for, many, many years, but not much fruit to share in his own lifetime. And of course, he also, had a son called Don Carson, which was helpful for the kingdom as well. But, we need to be careful to apply, too much business stricture on what ministry outcomes are. So patience, so partnership, permission, and patience. So if I'm a minister, those are things that I want to look for in the person whom I'm approaching as a potential patron.